Good morning students, in this video we are going to solve question number 1 of exercise 7.2. Now the question is, which congruence criterion do you use in the following? Students, here in each sub question, figures of two congruent triangles are given and between these two congruent triangles, corresponding equal parts are also given. And we have to identify by which congruent criterion these two triangles are congruent. Now, first question, here two congruent triangles are given, that is triangle ABC and triangle DEF. And between these two congruent triangles, equal parts are AB is equal to D, side AB is equal to D, AB and its corresponding side is DE. Therefore, these two sides are equal, that is given. BC is equal to EF, BC is equal to EF, and AC is equal to DF, AC is equal to DF. Therefore, students, we observe here, three sides of one triangle are equal with corresponding three sides of another triangle. Therefore, by SSS congruence criterion, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, students, we can write here, by SSS congruence criterion, therefore, we can say that here, triangle ABC congruent to triangle DEF by SSS congruence criterion, that is side congruence criterion. Now next question, here in this question figures of two congruent triangles are given, that is triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, and between these two triangles equal parts are, corresponding equal parts are ZX is equal to RP, here ZX is equal to RP, RQ is equal to ZY, here RQ is equal to ZY, means this side equal and this side equal. Now next, angle PRQ is equal to XZY, angle PRQ means this angle equal with angle XZY, XZY means this angle. Therefore, students, we observe here two sides and angle between them of one triangle are equal with corresponding two sides and angle between them of another triangle. Then these two triangles are congruent by side angle side congruence criterion, that is SAS congruence rule. Therefore, we can say here triangle PQR congruent to triangle XYZ, these two triangles are congruent by SAS congruence criterion. Therefore, by SAS congruence criterion, in this way, these two triangles are congruent by SAS congruence rule. Next question, C. In this question, two triangles are triangle LMN and triangle GFH. And between these two triangles, given equal parts are, corresponding equal parts are angle MLN and angle FGH are the equal angles. Therefore, angle MLN means this angle and angle FGH, FGH, that is this angle. Therefore, these two angles are equal angles. Now next, angle NML and angle GFH, angle NML, that is this angle, and GFH, GFH. Therefore, these two angles are also equal angles. between these two triangles. And ML is equal to FC. Means this ML is equal to FC. It is given. And these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, students, we observe here two angles and included side of one triangle are equal with corresponding two angles and included side of another triangle. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by angle side angle congruence criterion. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by ASA congruent rule. Therefore, we can write here by ASA congruent criterion. Therefore, by ASA congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent. Next question, D. Students, here two triangles are triangle ABE and triangle CDB. These two triangles are congruent. That is given, triangle ABE congruent to triangle CDB. And given corresponding equal parts between these two triangles are EB is equal to DB. EB is equal to DB. These two sides are equal. Now next, AE is equal to BC. AE is equal to BC. Now these two sides are equal. Now next, angle A is equal to angle C is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, both these angles are 90 degree angles. Therefore, angle A and angle C, both angles are equal. Therefore, students, we observe between these two triangles, right angle equal, hypotenuse equal, side AE equal to side BC. Therefore, these two sides are equal. Therefore, we observe here, right angle, hypotenuse, side of one triangle are equal with corresponding right angle, hypotenuse and side of another triangle. Therefore, by RHS congruence criterion, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, we can write here by RHS congruence criterion, these two triangles are congruent, or by RHS congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent. That is, triangle ABE congruent to triangle CDB. Students, I hope it is clear to you. Thank you.